Unit 2 Case Study Flight Information Report. Your assignment is to create a program to list all related flight information, then assign a transaction in the SAP Easy Access menu Favorites. Finally, you have to organize the objects inside a package and release the development for transportation. So basically, we're going to create a change request, we're going to create a package, we're going to create the program, then we're going to assign the transaction, and finally we're going to release the change request. So first of all, let's create our change request. Let's navigate to transaction SE01. We click on New, Workbench Request, and we click OK. Short description, this will be the flight information report request. So we save it. Now we have to give it a type, so we select change type, and it's going to be a development correction change request. Now, once we have our change request created, now let's create our package. So we go back to the SAP Easy Access menu, and we go to the Object Navigator, and we create the package Z Flight. Flight. So we press enter. Then the system asks us if we want to create the package C flight. Yes, I want to create it. And this will be the package for the flight information. Application component. We are not going to choose an application component at this time. Remember to use the software component as home and to check as the main package. And we save. We select our change request. That will be the flight information report. And our package is created. Now we're going to create the program. So we right click on the package, create program. We're going to name this program C Flight Report. We uncheck top include. The title is going to be a nice title for our program, Flight Information Report, executable program, and then we save it. We save it to our package ZFlight. We get an error that we cannot extend our package, so we have to modify our package. Remember that step that we forgot. So we go back. Yes, I want to cancel. I double click my package and I uncheck main package and I press enter, and I uncheck package not extendable and I press enter, and I save my package. Now I'm ready to create my program. Create program C fly report without the top include. Flight information report. We save it inside our package. Now it allows us to save. We select our change request. And now we can start typing our program. At this moment, we haven't learned about ABAP statements, so let's just type this program exactly as I tell you to. Later on, we're going to learn about all these ABAP statements. So let's start typing data. So we type all of this ABAP code. Right now may be a good idea to pause this video if you want to type all these instructions. When you're done typing, we can go ahead and save, check the syntax, and activate the program. This program basically extracts all the information, all the flight information, and it prints it to the screen. After activating our program, we can run it to see the result, and we can see all the flight information printed to the screen. So now we go back, and now we want to assign a transaction to our program. So we right click on the name of our program, create transaction. So let's give it code ZFlight01, and this will be the flight information report, and we select program name selection script report transaction. Now we type in the program ZFlight report and we save our transaction in our package and inside our change request. Now we have our transaction created. Let's try it. Let's go back to the SAP Easy Access menu. Let's type ZFlight01 and press enter. And as you can see, our program is executed and our flight information is listed to the screen. Now we want to release the change request so we can transport our development to the production system. So we go back to the transport organizer and we display all of our workbench requests that they have the status modifiable. And we look for the flight information change request. So now we have to release the task first, and then we release the change request. Now we wait for a little bit. It takes a while for the system to release all the objects of the change request. Once it is released, we are going to be ready to transport our development object to the production system. In this case, the system shows us that the release for the request ended with return code 012. This is because I haven't set up yet a production system and I haven't configured everything to transport to the production system. But in a real life scenario, your basis team will have that ready for you to just release the request and transport your objects to the production system.